So I've made it here to Woody Gap. It's about, I don't know, 6:45 in the morning. About 27 degrees and a little windy. It's definitely cold. The temperature should be going up pretty soon. As soon as the sun comes up, it's supposed to climb, I don't know, a good, at least 10 degrees throughout the day, maybe up into the 40s. So we should have a little bit better hiking weather pretty soon, but right now it is still pitch black. The moon's still out. You can still see stars in the sky, so I'm gonna throw my headlamp on and get started. You have to check this out. This is so peaceful and beautiful out here. The sun, you can see it starting to come up. The sky's a little bit brighter on the horizon. Sun just peeked over the horizon and it is gorgeous. I wish the video could capture what I'm actually seeing here. It just can't. These footprints go pretty deep. Jeez. Need some snowshoes for walking in here. The temperature has risen to about 45 degrees, and I'm feeling it for sure. I've already shed all of my outer layers, and I'm still pretty hot going uphill, although downhill feels great, and the cold wind feels good right now. So just taking a brief rest. I'm about, probably 4 miles in, and it's almost 9:30. It's been some slow going uphill. A lot of the sections going up and downhill are very icy from the foot traffic that's been on it for the last couple of days. And I haven't been able to film as much as I want to either, because I'm having to use my trekking poles to avoid slipping and falling on the ice. So, about to get up and hit back and get up to the Blood Mountain shelter, and I'm gonna try to get there by lunch, but I'll probably have to stop before then to have something to eat, since we're still a good 5 miles away right now, and it's what, 9 o'clock, 10, 11. I might make it up there by lunch. We'll see. This section of the trail has a lot of very powdery snow. Pretty much no ice at all, which makes it a lot easier walking. Every now and then, you find a rock or a root or something, but for the most part, it's a pretty easy stroll right now. Of course, going downhill helps. It's always easier going downhill. I passed another solo hiker about a quarter mile back. He was taking a break for some breakfast or a snack or something. But these trails, or this trail I should say, looks fairly well traveled considering how much snow was dumped on here in the last couple of days. But that one hiker is the only one I've seen. I passed the Lance Creek campsite a few miles back, and I saw evidence of where a few tents were set up overnight. You could see the square where the ice and snow was melted on the rock. So it's definitely been getting some backpacking overnight use in the last day or two. So I checked my GPS. We are about 4 miles from the Blood Mountain Overlook. So I was a little farther along than I thought I was, which is good, because if I was where I thought I was, and my pace was very slow for what I usually do. So most of the time in North Georgia, I try to maintain a pace of about, 2.5 to 3 miles per hour. 3 miles per hour if I can. It all depends on how steep the inclines are, what the terrain, how technical the terrain is. And also how well I've rested, how well I've eaten, how much I've been exercising, all that stuff kind of comes into play. So anyway, I'll check in a little bit later. I'm gonna try to pick up speed a little bit and get to the overlook by lunchtime. All right, I get to film much of this earlier, but this is some really, really deep snow. Let me see if I can catch it. It's not quite as deep as what I went through earlier today. This is only about maybe 14, 15 inches. The other stuff was way up my calf. Now, fortunately, somebody else has already been through here. It has made a lot of deep footprints in the snow, so I don't have to forge my own way. Oh. But this is what I was talking about, how it really slows down your pace, makes you work a little bit harder. Because I think navigating this kind of snow without snowshoes, it's definitely tricky at best. Hopefully these big snowdrifts don't last too much longer, because this is not fun. Going side to side, high knees through this deep snow. All right, looks to be thinning out a little bit up ahead. I'm on a downhill section right now. Is a nice little break, but there's a couple of up and downs as I slowly make my way to the top of Blood Mountain. And I gotta tell you, I am not looking forward to that climb up to the top. The last, I don't know, 3/4 of a mile probably, maybe 1 mile, is pretty steep, and not in the kind of shape I wanted to be in for doing a hike like this. I have no concerns about making it. It's just gonna slow me down a lot more than I'd like to. And I've got, let's see, I'm 5 miles in right now, so my legs are starting to feel it. No laughing, those of you who do hiking all the time, I don't. And I'm kind of a big guy, you know. A lot of people who do lots of hiking, they're a smaller frame, smaller bone structure, lighter weight. So when I was a freshman in high school at 14, I weighed 190 pounds. And I was very lean, 190 pounds. You know, played football and baseball, wrestling. And I couldn't gain weight from that point to save my life, you know. All my football coaches thought I was gonna be huge, you know, 6'2", you know, maybe 6'2", 220. And I got a lot stronger over my high school football career, but I just didn't put on any weight. So anyway, so I've always had a larger bone and muscle structure than most people do. And you really notice it when you're climbing uphill, whether it's on a mountain bike or hiking with a pack on, it really makes a big difference on your pace. So anyway, I've got that structure, and then I just turned 33, right? Yeah, 33, and so I've got, you know, I have a desk job, so I sit at a desk all day, and that takes its toll too when you have a lifestyle like that. And and then of course, you know, 3 kids, so I've got 3 kids worth of Halloween candy every October, and then Thanksgiving just went by, so lots of good eating there. And my wife does this cookie swap thing with other people in the neighborhood, and so there's whole boxes of cookies around, and I like eggnog, so that's tons of calories right there. And you know, and it's a busy time of year, and so the workouts are less frequent, and all that adds up to carrying more weight up this mountain today. So all that to say, I'm thankful for this downhill section to give me a little bit of a break. I can kind of stride it out, and before we start that grueling climb up to the top. So I'm gonna put the camera up for now, and I probably won't check back in. Big rock right there. I probably won't check back in until I get to the top, or at least until I take a break and get something to eat. So I'm really looking forward to that. It's 10 o'clock right now. I got up to leave my house this morning at 5, about 4:45, and I had some eggs and a banana back then. So I'm really looking forward to my tuna wrap that I'm carrying behind me. All right, more trekking through the snow, still going downhill. Blood Mountain shelter here, and the view is just beautiful. I wish there was a way to get the camera to see what I actually see, because it just doesn't do it justice. It's just so beautiful here. The
visibility is fantastic. You can see for a long, long way. The last couple miles, getting up here, go around this way, look at the shelter up here. The last couple miles getting up here were quite difficult. I was not anticipating quite as much difficulty in the snow. Every step sliding just a little bit, and that definitely made each step a little more challenging than I was expecting. And my pack weight was a little bit high. There's a couple things I could probably do away with, but since this was a fairly short hike and I'm not through hiking, I didn't bother dropping that extra weight. So the funny thing is, I didn't really take much of a break all the way up here. Just kind of hiked through it, pausing here and there to stretch my legs a little bit. But when I took my pack off, I sort of couldn't keep my balance very well. Because I was so used to having that pack behind me. But I definitely felt so much lighter. It was incredible how much lighter it felt having that pack off. The difference was just amazing. So right now I'm just kind of exploring a little bit. I'm cooling off a little from my hike up. And in a minute I'm going to go back around this way. I'm gonna heat up my stove and make some coffee. I could use some warm liquid right now. Passed by a father-son duo just before I started filming this. They were hiking out from, I guess, from Neil's Gap. And they're hiking on through, I guess, down to Woody Gap or Girard or something. Tell the weather's warming up because a lot of the stuff that used to be snow and ice is now very slushy. I'm not using my trekking poles right now, so I'm really hoping I don't slip and fall. The leaves off the trees, we actually get a pretty good view right now. You can see for a long, long way. There you go. Awesome. All right. I'm going to get off my feet for a little bit, back here at the shelter, and get these boots off, let them air out a little bit, put my sandals on. I've got my outer shell, my rain jacket, airing out. I think it got a little bit of a condensation inside it. When I took it off, it was warm on the inside, and then I stuffed it up into a pocket on my bag. And when I opened it back up again, I was going to put it on to block some of this wind, but when I put it back on, it had little water droplets all inside it, so I just stuck that in the windowsill in the sunlight, let that dry out. And I think I'll also need to I'll also need to dry out some of my other outerwear as well. Alright, well, that's basically it for now. I'm going to set up my little camp inside the shelter here, and then start heating up some coffee.